What is up, guys? My name is FluxedEdge, and today I'm going to be bringing you a tutorial on how to transfer Illustrator Vector to Cinema 4D and turn it into a 3D object, like I did in my Empty Streets video that I have on my channel. So, to start off, you want to go onto your browser, and you want to search for something that you want to change into a 3D object. So, for me, in my video, I'm going to change a logo into that I download off the internet into the object for Cinema 4D. So I'm going to go ahead and type in Japanese logo. I'm going to go to images. And the most important thing when you're trying to turn an image off of the web into a vector item is to have an image that's very clear and has a very contrasty background from the logo, like this one, where you see that the background is actually white and the logo is black. That's gonna turn into a vector a lot easier than something like something more complex like this. You'd have to go ahead and make selections, and it would just be a lot harder to do it. So we're gonna go on with the tutorial with this specific logo, and I'm gonna go ahead and just right click this. And I just like to say this image is 546 by 383, so it's a fairly small image. If you can get a larger image, that would be better. If you can't, this will still work. It just might have a few little changes in the actual logo from the one that you found. So I'm gonna go ahead and right click this, save as, and then I'm not sure why this box is so small, but I'm gonna save it here as logo. Now I'm gonna go into Adobe Illustrator, file, new. I'm gonna have my blank canvas. It doesn't matter the size. Because with Illustrator, your vector can be expanded endlessly and it will not distort. Now I'm going to go into my file folder and I'm going to drag the logo onto the canvas. Now as you can see, it's actually pretty blurry, like I said. So in order to trace this into a vector object, you want to click on it, then go to Object, Image Trace, Make. And now everything is turned into a vector. And as you can see, some of the lines are slightly different than they were. It's not as crisp and clean. If you want to edit that and make it more precise, you can. But for the sake of this tutorial and not making it too long, I'm just going to leave it as it is. So first thing you want to do is, if you realize and drag this over here, you can see that there's a black background. Cinema 4D is just going to read this object as a square, and it's just going to turn into a 3D object as a cube, and that's not something that you want. So you want to click your direct selection tool. Actually, you can do this with your regular selection tool. Just have it highlighted, the whole thing, and then go to Object and Expand. So once you have this box up, make sure everything is checked that you can. Stroke usually isn't because there's no stroke on this. And hit OK. And now you've separated this white background from the black logo. So this is where you want your direct selection tool, and you can select this background and you can delete it. Now, as you can tell, let me zoom in here. Oops, too far. Your text is very messed up, and that is due to the small image size. You don't want that text just because it is distorted, but I recommend just going ahead in Cinema 4D and finding a font that is a lot smaller, or you can find one in Adobe Illustrator and manipulate it and transfer it over like we're going to transfer this logo. But once again, for the sake of this, I'm not going to keep this text. I'm just going to delete it because I don't need it. Next thing you want to do is you'll notice these two white spots that are still, or three white spots that are still in this logo. I'm going to click on it and delete all of these because I don't need them, and we want to show the actual see-through, the holes in the 3D object when it gets moved into Cinema 4D. So next I'm going to highlight everything, and I'm going to go to File, and I'm going to go Save As. Now I'm going to use Logo 1, Save, and then wait for the next dialog box to come up. And this is where the important part to make it compatible with Cinema 4D happens. So in order to actually make it work, you have to change the version, and version number Illustrator 8 is what you want to use. I haven't tested all the other ones, but I know that this one works, and if you just stick it as Illustrator CS6, it's probably not going to work. It might not do anything at all. Some of the other versions will just give you errors. So hit 8, you can't change anything else at this point, and you'll get a warning, but don't worry about it because it's just saying something about a legacy format, and hit OK. Now you're going to want to go into Cinema 4D, and this is pretty easy. So File, Merge Objects, and then click on this logo file that you saved, and it should be an Illustrator file. Open. And now this is where it gets a little weird. I didn't used to have to do some of these steps, but by default, you're probably going to have Connect Splines checked. I don't want it checked. It used to be able to keep it checked and everything would work out, but due to some errors I've been getting in this new updated Cinema 4D, it doesn't work with Connect Splines. So make sure you uncheck that and hit OK. And you don't need to change the scale. So as you can see, we have our logo and it's not in the center of the canvas. So I'm going to go ahead and make my extrusion, drag it into the extrusion, and then I'm going to change the coordinates on that with the logo highlighted to 0. Oops. That way it centers it on the extrude object, which is already in the center when you create it. So after you're at this point and you have your logo as a child of the extrusion, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you have all of these selected, each individual path. So I'm just clicking on the first one, holding shift, and clicking on the last one so it selects everything in between. Then I'm going to right click. And actually, before I do that, I'm going to show you what happens if you don't do this. So if you click on this extrude, you're going to notice normally when you put something in an extrusion, it makes it 3D. So if I were to take one of these paths up and drop it as a child of this, it will make that object 3D. Problem being, we want everything in this null to be 3D instead of just one individual piece at a time. So I'm going to make sure I click this, which takes the hierarchy and everything in order, and it makes it 3D all at once. Now, if you want, you can make individual extrusions for each path, but preferably to keep everything consistent, this is what I like to do. And now you're going to notice that if I turn this off, we're missing our holes in the character. And we obviously need those, or it doesn't look like the logo is supposed to. And I'm not sure exactly what this says, but it's probably not right. So what you need to do is you need to select all of these, like I said before. So shift, or click on the first one, hold shift, click on the last one, select everything. Then right click and connect objects plus delete. And that should open up the holes in your object. That way you get the logo just how you want it to be, or how it's supposed to be. Now you can do things with the extrusion like you could if you used it with anything else. You can add caps to it to stylize it a little bit. So let me do that. Add a fillet cap, and then one, and it makes it look a little better. And then from here, you can texture this however you want. Add some color if you want. Drag it on, and you have a very, very basic 3D logo. And that is actually all I have for today. If you have any questions or you run into any issues, please let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to help you out and maybe even make another video on how to do something a little more complex than just this. So thank you for watching.